down, everybody. Welcome back to Minecraft. We are back once again in my little world over here. We got our nice little stable over here and whatnot. Yeah, everything's looking pretty good at the moment. And yeah, let me quickly just pull back up some stuff. Yeah, and built this little stable over here the other day. Got some chickens, got my horses, my donkey, my mule. All in there just chilling now rather than just, you know, being all over the show. Speaking of which, I could probably take out this fence post here. And there's another one over here by the house. Just take this on out. Dang trapdoors. They look so good. Alrighty then. I've been busy. Not so much around here though. We'll go check that out in a second. But what we're going to be working on for a couple of hours, maybe an hour, hour and a half-ish today, is over here. So if you guys remember from the first few live streams, see all these paths, this used to be a village. So there used to be houses up here and whatnot. But what I want to do, what I'm going to do, is I'm going to build like a custom trading village over here. And it will come all the way around here, down and around here, and around our starter base. So the starter base is going to become, you know, part of the trading village, essentially. And then we'll also have like a little dock over here by the lake, you know, like a little fishing platform and stuff. But then we're going to have like a bunch of little houses, well, a bunch of houses basically. So we'll probably put the librarians in the starter house here. But we'll have like, you know, like a little farming area where we'll have a bunch of farming villages, a blacksmith's, you know, a mason's, a leather working station, armor and toolsmith will probably be one building. You know, an archery range for fletchers, you know, a little magical area for our clerics. And we're just going to try and fit it all in this area here. Not too sure how far we're going to go back and how far up this way we're going to go. Probably not too far past this lake because I don't want villagers falling down here. But we can bring it up this way a little bit and a bit down. But we're going to have to wall this off. So we're going to have to build a wall, basically. And also, we're going to have, like, one main entrance, I think, on each side. And we'll probably do some 3x3 piston doors for that, because I think that would be awesome. But obviously, first we're going to have to build the wall before I even bother trying to get villagers in there. We do have a villager breeder down there, so we can easily move villagers into it. Because what we're going to have is we're going to have houses, essentially. And inside those houses, we'll have villager trading stalls. And then we'll just have some random villagers that walk around the that can walk around the area. Might build like a little dormitory kind of, so they have beds and stuff, and then they can walk around, and that creates, you know, that sense of life in that village, in this area, right? Even though those villagers won't have any jobs or anything like that. They might do, but they won't be the villagers that we trade with. So yeah. Yeah, we've already got some tracks down here so we can transport villagers from here to wherever we need to take them. We already do have some villagers in here next to the villager breeder, which is currently turned off. We can turn that on later, but that's fine. So last live stream, we were busy working over here, over there in the industrial district. So let's go over to the industrial district. I did fix the alignment of the border. So it's actually 13 by 13 chunks, all chunk aligned quite nicely. And the next episode of Bob's World, episode 4, is coming out tomorrow morning, where we build this shulker farm here. So if I just go to my little AFK spot here. Oop. Almost had it that time. Just gotta wash off a little speed. There we go. But if I just jump in here. Come in here. Oh yeah, we get zombified piglins in here too, but we got our snow golems, we got our shulker, and then doosh. And this is working pretty well. I've already got, I AFK'd for like an hour and a half yesterday, or last night. Last night, yeah, AFK for about an hour and a half last night, and got like 4 stacks of shulker cells, so that's pretty good. And that's going to provide us with all the shulker shells that we need for our central storage system that's going to be down here eventually. But this is the first farm we got in the industrial district, which is dope. Okay, cool. Everything still seems to be running just fine. There is a mechanism to get another shulker back in that farm if need be, but I haven't built that yet because I don't think I'm going to need it. But when I do, I'll build it. But until that point, like, it already took me, how long did it take me to build this? Like, this is probably like a 4-hour build, 4 or 5 hour build, including, you know, what's on the nether side. So yeah, all right, let's head back on home. Still need a name for the pooch though. Anyone got a good idea for a name for the pooch? Also, I'm not going to upgrade this world to 120.5 just yet. I'm just going to wait for 120.1 to come out. And then we'll upgrade everything to 1.21 when that comes out in June. So I'm going to hold off upgrading this world until then. Then we get access to the autocrafter and things like that, which I'm really looking forward to. And then we can, you know, I can actually have like a fully automatic rocket factory, which would be dope, which means building another creeper farm in the industrial district. So that's fine by me. So yeah. We got a few things to work on today. Well, mainly this wall. So I'm gonna go grab some blocks, and we're gonna mark this out, I think. Obviously, we won't move the librarians into here until we get the... Well, until we at least get the storage system of our new base built up there, which I'm still working on at the moment. You know what? I'm just going to make some bone blocks, I think. Screw some bone blocks. Stack of them. Perfect. We'll use bone blocks to mark this out. I think we should start out over here, I think. I don't want to have this in as, you know, straight lines as possible. Which means we might level out the middle of it a little bit. Take out, like, this hill and stuff. Because I just want a flat area for it. But yeah, I think... Might even use bone blocks in the build. I'm not entirely decided yet. But I was looking at some interesting wall designs already this morning, just to try and get some inspiration for what the wall could look like. But yeah, we run it all the way across here. I think down to about here-ish. Be good. Seeds? What the damn seeds? Try and walk this out in as much of a straight line as possible. Yeah, we will be removing that iron farm shortly, I think. Alright, let's quickly go and have a nap. Get this back over to daytime. I love Mini Hard for doing these things. Okay, so where is this one? 537. That's a pretty big area. I like it. Just use free cam and let's just see. Oh no. There's going to be plenty of room for what we're going to do, be building, so I think that's good. And then I think what we can do is we can have, I think we put an entrance over here actually. Yeah, just want to mark out a couple of entrances. I really do want to do piston doors, but we might not do that. All right. Have an entrance there. Sure, I line up this entrance with where the wall's going to be. Well, this will probably be where the center of the wall's going to be. Up there. I think I will use bone blocks because I've just got so many bones from the skeleton farm and stuff, and it's, I think it'll work out quite well. Damn skeletons. You can't mess me up, man. My armor's too good. I want your bits. But I do want to age some copper, so let's have a quick look at what we've got here. Then what we're going to probably have is we're probably going to have a repeatable pattern. So we'll have, you know, repeatable chunks for the wall. Nothing too fancy. Just something that's going to do the job. And it will also help us light up the rest of this area, because that zombie just spawned in and he hasn't spotted me yet, which is great. But yeah, obviously we might change these entrances based on, like, it's not going to be exactly in the middle, and I don't want it to be in the middle. I don't want to have it line up with this path, because there will be, you know, some way of getting up here where you don't have to go into the cave, essentially. So there might be a staircase that winds up there, and then, yeah, maybe that will be the path up, and we might have another path that comes up this way. Might actually build a bridge from here over there, maybe. It's kind of what I'm thinking. Just gotta take care of this dang zombie. I'll leave him. And also it means we will be able to eventually get rid of all these torches and light the area up with some better lighting. But yeah, now I think the next thing to do is to play around with wall designs and see what is going to work the best, I think. And before we can do that, we're going to need a bit of wood, because I think a fair chunk of this wall is probably going to have be made out of wood, I think. Because it's a wall for a village, you know? Villages don't have, you know, access to all the greatest resources. So what we're going to do is we're probably just going to build it out of wood and some copper, which I should do now. Should hopefully get me a stack of copper blocks. Cool. I do want to integrate copper into the wall design. Also, I built some lampposts in the original Bob's World that I might reuse here too. Lay this out, 4 blocks space in between. just want this copper to oxidize. The last of these laid out. Away, horse. Alright, well, it's a temporary copper field at the moment, but I kind of like using oxidized copper on piston doors. I did it in Bob's World V1 and on my mountain base, and I quite liked it. So we might do the same thing here. I'm not entirely sure yet. But I need to go chop down some trees. Chop down the trees over here at the tree farm first. Before we go flying around too much. Chop down these big spruce boys from the top. Get the old rhythm going and chop down these trees. The idea here is to get as close to the center of all four logs as possible and just hold shift to crouch, and when you're crouching you won't actually fall down once you chop out the block underneath you. This makes it way quicker, I've found personally, to chop down these big trees. Yes, you could staircase, you know, spiral staircase up the trees to chop them down, but once you've got an elytra, this is the easiest way to chop down these big bear boys. Let me set one up over there a little bit. Just that'll do. Because technically my hitbox is across not just the log I'm standing under, but the ones to the side of me, I believe. Hence why I just don't fall down straight away after chopping out the block from underneath me. It just makes doing this super quick. And obviously everyone's got their own way that they like to chop down these trees. This is just the fastest way I've found. I've got efficiency 5 on my axe, so it'll take a lot to chop down these trees. And also, you know, it's making really small movements with my mouse, so it's not really annoying on my hands or anything. Yeah, I'll just chop down these oak trees. These ones are way easier. I should start getting them with the leaves like that. Shut up, cows. No more logs, no more logs. Thank you. Alright, we got some logs on the go now. I'll pick up as many saplings as I can so I can replant all these trees. Because, you know, sustainable farming. Alright, thanks for the follow. Appreciate that very much. How's it going? How's your weekend? Pretty good. Just chilling with some Minecraft. Oh, roll that up. Let's place that settling. Yeah, I play quite a lot of Minecraft. I also play some 7 Days to Die. Yeah. Fortnite. Not a big fan of Fortnite. I tried playing it once, but, you know, I don't think I'll be playing Fortnite again anytime soon. My Discord is the same as the Twitch channel. So yeah, you can just find me on Discord as the man simply known as Bob, which is the same as the Twitch channel, so, and also the YouTube channel, so feel free to send me a message over there if you want to. Alright. Oh, that's oxidizing already. Ah, not these guys again. God dang it, guys. Do you have to? Alright, I'm gonna leave those guys to do whatever it is they want to do. Yeah, thank you. I'll probably check that out after I've finished streaming. Right, I'm going to cut down some trees back here. There's some spruce and there's some more oak and birch out this way. So I'm going to chop down a bunch of these trees. I'll get a shulker box full of various woods. That would be great. We're going to have to play around with a couple of different things. Nah. Not actually too sure what we're going to build out the back here eventually. But if I end up clearing up most of these trees, I'm not too fussed about it. I can always come back here and replant them anyway. I will have a look at that that request after I'm finished streaming. I'm kind of in the middle of gathering resources right now. Alright, let's just drop some of this back in here. I need more birch, that's what I really need right now. Maybe I'll see if I can find an old birch forest around here somewhere. As opposed to a standard forest. Come back for the spruce later, but we had an old birch. Oh, yep, we've got an old growth birch forest over here. Stands out over here. Might just take some birch from here, I think. I think strip birch will look really good with bone blocks, actually. Not 100% sure on that, but we'll find out. Dark oak forest over there too. We got some dark oak too. Keep my shulker box on me. I think that zombie's gonna come over and say hello. Did no one ever teach this zombie that you shouldn't really, you know, try to say hello to people that have axes? And particularly when you're on fire. Because you might just get, you might just get dead. We'll grab some of these saplings. I'm going to get a tree farm set up shortly. Well, soon-ish. That way we won't need to come out and do more deforestation. Silly zombie. All right, have a quick snooze. Here's my turtles. Here's the spider farm and the creeper farms back out over that way a little bit more. Let's grab up the last of these birch trees that are here. Ooh, all right. That should be good for now on the birch. Do want some dark oak. Could pull her up, but I just cannot be bothered. I don't want all the dark oak saplings. Chocobo box again. Alright, I want some spruce. Some more spruce. We can get from over here. Note to self, good source of mossy cobble. Oh, creeper. Sneak up on me like that now, don't you? I have plenty of spruce saplings, I don't really need any more. It's drowned. Like, what's that gargling? Just drowned. Even quicker, just a staircase up this one. That's why I'm not wasting rockets. Chop down this tree and then head back home. I think we're going to have enough wood for now. You can always come back out here and get some more. The only problem with staircasing like this though is that a zombie or a creeper could climb up here. I kind of do the same thing as what I was doing before. Dang it. Really? Come on. No way. Cheek of that skeleton. Zombie villager. Alright, I'm out of here. Let us go. Yeah, well, the getting was good. get our shulker box placed down. Oh yeah, also, that's how many shulker boxes, shulker shells I got from the new shulker farm when I did a bit of AFK. Just over three and a half stacks there. I thought it was four, but three and a half for like an hour and a half worth of AFK. Good by me. Do we have some cocoa beans? Say hello to our wood box. Alright guys, just give me a second, I'll be back shortly. Alright, I'm back. Alright. Yeah, let's see what else we can quickly put together here in the realm of shulker boxes. What color dye are you? No. Have to make some grey dye, I think. That one. Alright. I'm gonna get a bunch of ore materials in here. That we can use for building. Use for building things. What else am I looking for? Granite for sure. Bit of a stone box going on now. It's great. Eventually we will have a well-organized ender chest, but it's going to take us a while to get there. Do I have any andesite? We're pretty good now. Now, Lytra's a little bit beat up at the moment, but that's fine. Actually, maybe what I can do right now. So I do have a spare elytra. Is I might quickly just enchant my spare elytra and put that in my utility box. Just to be on the safe side. Come on, I'm breaking through. Come on. Dang it. Just give me Unbreaking 3. What do I have downstairs? Nada. Oh. Yeah, you want to give me Unbreaking 3. All right. I need to go get 5 levels very quickly. Getting a bit sidetracked here. Come on. You know, I could also made this with just a cactus so it doesn't have the lava sound, but the lava just seems better. Come on. Three more levels. Let's go. Come on. Yeah, I think maybe for tomorrow's live stream we might build the Enderman farm because this takes too long to get levels out of, and I did see a really interesting Enderman farm design the other day, so kind of want to build that. And it kind of uses, does it use minecarts or is it a boat or something? I can't quite remember, but it's a really interesting Enderman farm design as opposed to like the standard one where you build a platform and you have an endermite and you drop the enderman and then you slice them up. The farm design, I think I'm going to build tomorrow. Apparently you can get 30 levels in a minute, which is pretty crazy if you ask me. But I was watching a YouTube video about the design and like the way it works, I can see how that's possible. So hopefully I can build that on stream tomorrow. Also, one way of increasing the rates at this farm would be to turn down my render distance quite a lot, but I'm not going to do that. I personally find that's a bit cheaty, a bit cheesy. Yeah. Another couple levels here and we should be all good. I've been meaning to enchant that extra elytra for a while, I just haven't got around to it. But now that I'm kind of starting to sort out my ender chest, I think it makes sense to do it now. Or else I won't get around to it. But this is definitely me sidetracking off of what was the plan. Yeah, that happens all the time though, so I'm not too worried about it. Come on, a few more skeletons and we should be good to go. hopefully this should be the last batch of skeletons that I need to kill. A couple more and we should be all good. Ooh. Finish my ginger beer, dang it. Come on. Stop fighting the flow of the water. I didn't really do a good job when I built the skeleton spawner farm. I just did it quick and dirty. Goddamn eerie noises. Alright, that does the job. I'm breaking three now. So I can enchant this other elytra and throw to my utility box. And then we can finally get around to wall designs. See, my good chest plate lives in the utility blocks, along with some spare tools and stuff. That's where that elytra can live too. Alongside my beacon. Grabbing some extra supplies I think we're going to need for the wall. Make some more bone blocks. What else might I want? That should do for now. All right, let's set up a little bit of a workstation over here. Stone box, grab the wood box. What did I do with the stone cutter? Just have to craft one. I know I have some stone in the stone box, but I did not want to use that to craft the stone cutter. Alright, let's quickly go pick up some of this copper. This didn't take too long to oxidize at all. Alright, that's all the oxidized copper for now. It's not bad, a quarter of it's already finished oxidizing. Okay, now what I'm kind of thinking. But I want the wall to be a bit chunky though. Actually, no. All right. don't know whether I like that. I'd actually swap one of those spruce pillars out for some bone blocks. Maybe even some birch. We'll try both. I want a little bit more contrast between them. I do like that. I think the bone block is better. We'll basically just have the same on this side. Something like that. Because I want to have lights inside the actual wall to help light areas up. Now, I don't want the frog lights being visible. It is, however, missing something. Thank you. It's too flat there. That's still... It's giving out all the light from this anyway. Because the light will go through the trapdoors. I don't know, still missing something. Let me go see what I've got in here. I don't know. I'm not sold, but I'm also not still really flat though. I kind of like that, but not sold yet. Now this is why we're going to experiment a little bit with a couple of different designs. I kind of like the height. Okay, let's just try something different. So, okay, here's something. I don't know though, it doesn't really. Yeah, something like that can work. Then I want to integrate lights into this somehow. This is where I start to get into thinking about something more like yeah, something more like that. And then that's starting to get into like tower territory. I don't think I want. I wonder whether we can get a happy medium between those two. Let's just see. You know what? I actually kind of like that. It takes this birch out. It's only 3 wide. A 3x3 area. And it looks like something, you know, a village would build. So I think I'm going to go with this. Means I should tear out all these other ones. I just really want to start using all these frog lights that I have. Then what do I want to have in between these? Because I'm not going to run these next to each other, I don't think. It's like I want a couple of different repeating patterns almost. That's not gonna work for me at all. Next idea. mind having a flat panel in between them. It would just be a case of, you know, making sure it makes sense. Maybe we could use some more spruce there. Let's just I don't know. Kinda like it. But I feel like this middle needs to be different. I think it's too same going on at the moment. I don't think this is going to help, but we'll try. Nah. To be a little bit darker, funnily enough. Spruce. mind it. It's not bad. I don't know. What are you guys thinking? I don't think it's terrible, but I don't like it either. Yeah, I'm definitely not sold on any of this right now. It's a bit of a shame, but I'm going to keep playing around with this until I figure something out. But yeah. I think that's pretty much all that I've got for today, guys. So thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.